Dodge Hockey on Altitude is brought to you by Dodge. Visit Dodge.com or your local dealer today. Frostbrewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Your Colorado Porsche dealers. To find one near you, visit Colorado.PorscheDealer.com. CenturyLink, a trusted technology partner, frees you to focus on what matters. CenturyLink, your link to what's next. And by Shortline Subaru. Save money. Drive better. Avalanche and the Flames meet for the second time this season. And for the Avalanche, coming off a loss last night in Edmonton as they continue on this Western Canada road swing. For the Flames, they've won their last two games, in each game giving up just one goal. Let's look at tonight's Ford starting lineup, and we'll start with the starting goaltender.
As scheduled, J.S. Jaguar in net tonight for the Colorado Avalanche. Boy, Mike, dude, the numbers speak for themselves when you look at J.S. Jaguar's record, 6-0, 1.62 goals against, 9.49 save percentage. He has been brilliant all season. The real interesting story for Calgary is the goaltending. Kerry Romo, Mike, was supposed to be the goaltender. He did not have a good start to the season. This guy and then that guy, and then now suddenly he's come back the last couple of games. 52 shots on goal, 50 saves.
Flames win the opening faceoff, and here we go. And the puck is in. Headed right in front of the Avalanche bench where it gets tipped and into the Avalanche bench. The puck has gone out of play early in our first period of action as we look at the rest of the forward lineup for the Avalanche. Any changes? Other we know that defensively they've had to change some things because of the injury to Jan Hayda. Anything among the forwards, Peter, different from last night?
Just talking with the coaching staff a little while before the game, I think they're going to, as they say, load up. Landeskog on the left side. Duchesne in the middle, McKinnon on the right side, which means O'Reilly, Parento, and Stastny will be this second line.
See that Corey Starch is back in the lineup, and he was a healthy scratch last night in Edmonton. Here's a chance for O'Reilly, bouncing puck in the side of the net. Scooped away, still pinballing around. One-handed up the far side boards. By Butler, out in the center, Habs get the puck back, shot in from center ice by Parento, and Romo. Set it up behind the net for Calgary. So Starch back in the lineup. Then the injury to defenseman Jan Hayda allows Nick Holden to stay in the lineup. But Eric Johnson paired up tonight with Nate Gennon with Hayda out. The Flames make an offside pass.
We will go back to the injury. We don't usually like to go to this, like if they're too graphic. But the situation is it looks more encouraging now than it did right at the time. Because you didn't know what had happened. I mean, somebody break his ankle like Robitaille. I mean, it was just a real tough injury to watch. But he flew home today. He had a little trouble getting out. I guess the plane took off and they had to come back. And he didn't end up getting there until 5 o'clock at night. But he is back in Denver being reevaluated tomorrow.
Flames have the puck, bounced up the boards. Little chip out towards center ice. Camilleri feeds it. Ahead, brought in Stepniak, being ridden against the boards by Nathan McKinnon. Jaguar winds the puck around the board. Jaguar, former Calgary Flame, 6-0 start to this season. Franchise record. Russell pinned up against the boards with a good hit by Landeskog. Centering pass for Camilleri, slipped past him, down the ice and back into the Calgary zone where Kari Ramo will set up the puck to be taken by T.J. Brody. Brody looks to his left, passes right. And the Flames, quick breakout pass for Camilleri. Went off his stick, Avs get it back. Talbot hooks the puck towards the corner, chased down by McGinn. He frees up the puck, but the Flames are on it. The pass right up the middle, gets by Berchi. All the way down the ice, there's a whistle as the Flames are called for icing.
Right. Because Jan Hayda was injured so early in the game, look at the numbers of the defensemen, the time of the defensemen as they played in last night's game. You see Nate Gannon, Mike, the most he played. Andre Benoit, the most he played. Eric Johnson, a pretty consistent number for him. But then Tyson Barrie, also over 20. You're going to want to back off on that. You know what? Most of them under 20, if you can, in tonight's game.
And part of that, Peter, because you're going back-to-back nights.
Well, it's back-to-back, then you're going to Vancouver, you got a 5 o'clock in, then you got a long flight home, then you play a tough Phoenix club. And you got to start saving your energy and really start moving that ice time around.
It's going to be a busy schedule for the Avalanche up until Christmas time. Puck bouncing around behind the net. Chased down by Blair Jones. Jones moving in, he turns, he shoots, and the save made by Jaguar. He just stayed up tall against that post and didn't give up anything. And the puck is flipped over the glass, and the play is whistled.
Right, we were talking to a couple of scouts after the game, in particular Billy Guerin, who works for Pittsburgh. Couldn't talk enough about McKinnon and just the way that he competed inside the game. Now, the Avalanche coaching staff doesn't want him, Mike, to get too emotional, too frustrated. You've got to stay in control. But at 18 years old, sometimes, you know, you can't always control it. They know that, but they want him to try.
Tip goes wide of the net. It'll pass out in front, blocked, and Cleese will get to it. There's some of that if you're Nathan McKinnon. Throughout your youth hockey, certainly into juniors, you've always been the star. Things have gone well for you. You've scored a ton of goals. You've been probably the best player on every team you've been on. So that was some of the frustration perhaps comes in. It's not as easy in the NHL.
It was certainly not as easy, but you know that. It's a fact, the numbers. You're out there, you're on the power play. The Avalanche power play goes 0-6. You're not used to that. Those types of things happening. It's not just that you're not the star. He knows he's got lots of star players in this team. It's the idea is when you've been mad before, you've gone out and you've usually scored. And now that just doesn't happen.
Bouncing puck along the boards in front of the team benches. Swatted back by Guerin. Played by Johnson. Sends it across for Guerin. Pass out to center ice. Johnson steps up. Nice pass over the line for Stastny. His shot goes high. And around the boards, O'Reilly. He'll slow things down. And the puck bounced back to the point. Shot by Johnson. And that one went off his stick. Wide of the net. Sent to the side. Pass in front for Stastny, but just tipped away in time by the Flames. Great chance there right in front of the net for the Avalanche. David Jones makes the pass. And back towards Jones. Intercepted. And O'Reilly will chip the puck out to center ice.
That was a nice read defensive by O'Reilly. He was in the perfect spot. That is a well set up play by the Flames.
Geared at him. Shoots the puck in. He missed 18 games. The broken foot came back and immediately had impact last game with a goal and an assist to help the Flames win. McKinnon takes the puck down to the corner. Followed up by Duchesne. McKinnon behind the net. Wraparound try denied by Ramo. McKinnon, Duchesne, and Landeskog. As Peter pointed out, putting some of the big pieces of the puzzle together on one line. Camilleri drop pass. Big shot missed wide by Stajan. And the puck travels out to center. Duchesne trying to chip it by the defenseman and get to it. But it's turned back out to center by Chris Russell and knocked in by the Avalanche. Played just about 5 minutes of hockey here in the first period. No score in our game. One shot for both clubs. Pass threads through. Bearsheet sends it over the line, near side. Shot by Jones, misses on the short side. Puck comes around to the far side point. Held in there by the Flames. Shane O'Brien. Scoop back around the boards. Talbot chased by O'Brien. Takes a hit from him. The puck lands in the corner. After the Coleman scored a goal last night. Got a number of family and friends attended the game. Grew up in a town just right outside of the city of Edmonton.
And they're all here.
They've made this trip, haven't they?
Yeah, absolutely. Including the maker of the sign.
As the puck comes back to the point for Benoit, we've got a whistle, and it appears we're going to have our first penalty. Now, last night, boy, it was a penalty-filled game at a total of 44 minutes of penalties last night. And here's the first call of the evening, and it goes against the Avalanche as John Mitchell is headed into the penalty box.
And this will be key, Mike, for the Avalanche. Last night, the Avalanche had an early penalty, power play, pardon me, that turned into a 5-on-3. They couldn't score on either end of the 5-on-3 or the 5-on-4. Moments later, it seemed, Edmonton had it and scored on both ends.
Power play number one for Calgary. Ranked 24th overall on the power play, but 14th in the league at home. Down low, chance. Jagr denied that opportunity. Rebound goes back to the far side. Hudler. He's had some very good games against the Avalanche. Went to the front of the net. Pass back towards Russell. Sends it across. Giordano feeds into the circle. Shot saved by Jagr. Loose puck right between the circles. Scooped up by the Flames. Played back to the point. Hudler gets the pass. Moving through the faceoff circle. Back to the point. Russell sends it across. Giordano moves in. His pass comes off the corner. Hudler. Watched by McLeod. McLeod, Cleese, was Guerin. And Holden out on the penalty kill for the Avalanche. Flames on the power play. Shot by Russell. That's blocked by McLeod. Giordano chases the puck down. John Mitchell in the penalty box. A holding penalty called at 5:32. Flames have the first power play of the game. Russell in the slot. Giordano with a chance in the glove. Save made by Giguere.
Well, a couple of things. Wow. Good passing by the Calgary Flames in that power play. The good movement. And again, if you watch a good power play, Mike, there's movement away from the puck. Everybody's trying to get open. There's nothing stationary. And I think that's one of the things that the Avalanche will be working on in power play tonight. But what a save by Giguere right at the end. A great glove save. Because he knows, Mike, the numbers tell you, the Avalanche get that first goal. They're just a different hockey team.
Flames have been good defensively of late. Just one goal against the last two wins for the Flames. Russell finds Brody. His shot right on. Saved by Giguere. And the puck comes free. Giguere was right there to make that save and prevent the rebound from going in as well. 35 seconds left in Mitchell's penalty. Flames have had the puck in the AV zone. Shot scored! Well, Giguere feels he was interfered with. There was a collision. And look at the body language of Giguere. Is he mad? Oh, is he really upset? And they just threw the net back. He jumped up after that goal. Threw the stick down, made obviously the body
he got
language
penalty.
That
he got another penalty.
It should not have been a goal.
Stepniak right there, Mike, again, where was he? Where was he in?
Well, the referee will say he was outside the crease,
outside,
right?
Outside the crease. But you know, for a goaltender, as he's trying to move out to make the play, you run into the guy now. You're right there. He's bumped into, but was he in the blue? His skates look to be in the blue, Mike. When you watch that, his skates look to be in the blue. His upper body is moved forward. We see that one again because, Mike, you're disagreeing. You're disagreeing. Can we see that one again, please? The one from the...
You're saying look at where his skates are.
Look where his skates are. Look where his skates are, Michael. Look at this skate, left skate. It's in the blue. It's in the blue when he is touched. Now he's moving forward. No, he gets the whole blue. He doesn't get part of it. He gets the whole blue. And now he's upset. And that's what he is saying. Now, is the referee coming out of the corner said that, no, you were outside of that. So, that you talk about a fine line in that situation.
Well, I think, Peter, not only the Avalanche have a power play goal scored on them, but I believe that Giguere is going to get called for a penalty.
As the referee went right over to the linesman and said, how did that net get moved? Get moved. And Giguere tried to do the old sweep the crease. Like I don't know how that happened, but the linesman had seen that.
So it's an unsportsmanlike conduct call after the goal by Russell. Chris Russell scoring his fourth goal of the season. Berchi gets the lone assist. And the goal coming at 7:01. Russell's power play goal. That's his second power play goal of the season. The penalty called on Giguere for unsportsmanlike conduct. And so another power play chance for the Flames. Russell's pass. Back towards Russell. Camilleri caught that pass in his skates. That allows O'Reilly to get to it. A little support from Stastny. And Stastny plays the puck down the ice. So it's 1-0 for the Flames on a power play goal. Another minute left in the penalty on Giguere. That's being served by McKinnon.
And if that first penalty kill was big, this is huge inside of this game.
Michael Backlund after the puck. Benoit and a chip along the boards. Stepniak got in the way. And the puck goes to the far corner. Set up back up to the far side wall for T.J. Brody. Flames defenseman slides it across. Giordano making his way through the faceoff circle. Put it into the corner. Berchi leads the puck along the boards. And tangled up. Benoit for the Avalanche. And this puck stayed along the outside. Back up the high slot. Held in by the Flames. Shot by Brody. Blocked in front. Still loose. Played up off the boards. Giordano bounced it. Back to the point. Giordano has the puck. Slides it across. One-timer. The stick save by Giguere. And that's directed over the glass into the netting out of play.
Well, the Avalanche have worked hard, but they've had to. This has been a really good couple of power plays for the Calgary Flames. And good movement. I mean, you know, this is a club, Mike, that struggled mightily earlier in the season, but a lot of it was defensively. You know, it's a club that will work hard. The Avalanche know that. They get bodies down low, and their defensemen are very underrated for their offensive ability.
By the way, first penalty of the season called on J.S. Giguere. Orlamo, tonight's backup goaltender for the Avalanche, also with one penalty this season. Well, the power play is done, so the Avalanche, important penalty kill there after the goal was scored on the power play, on the first power play opportunity by defenseman Chris Russell. So the Calgary Flames lead it 1-0. Flames leading it 1-0 in the first period here in Calgary at the Saddle Dome. A power play goal from Chris Russell. And this faceoff in the Avalanche zone, Peter, much of this first period has been in the Avalanche zone.
It was, you know, the back and forth, but the two power plays, Calgary moved the puck well, and now they have that offensive momentum. We've talked about when you have a good power play, you really move it, your top guys are in the game.
Steal by Landeskog, who shoots the puck down the ice. This is the sixth time in seven home games for the Flames that they are playing a team that had played the night before. They've certainly taken advantage of it. They certainly did against the Phoenix Coyotes the last home game win. The puck is covered by the goaltender Kari Ramo. And a faceoff coming up in the Calgary zone. Why don't we look at who is in the group? Brought to you by Groove Subaru.
I'll tell you, for Eric Johnson, just being Eric Johnson, it must feel so good. This is a guy that everybody, you know, talk about. He's a number one pick overall. Was he ever going to fulfill his promise? Well, he's fulfilling his promise. There is one guy in the league that's better than his plus 17. His plus, can you imagine he was plus two last night? In an 8-2 loss.
I mean, it was interesting talking to him before the game and about the fact that now, I mean, certainly you have develop that relationship with your defensive partner on the ice, and without Jan Hayden, now Nate Gannon, but he was so quick to talk about the fact that Gannon's a right-handed shot and what kind of adjustment that is. Peter, can you explain why that's such a big deal?
It's where you pass, Mike. You're passing forehand to forehand. Now you're passing forehand trying to get to the backhand of a guy. You can really, really put a guy in a hole. Or does he have to turn his body and take it on the forehand? Most coaches around the league love that left-right combination in their defensive partners.
Jones plays the puck back to the point. Shot into the corner. And the Avalanche will take it out to center ice. It's Parenteau for the Avalanche. He had a goal last night in the game against the Edmonton Oilers. Flames get the puck back. Tipped out to center ice. Handed off to Yuri Hudler. And he'll backhand it into the Avalanche zone.
And there are obvious guys that will turn it the other way. Bobby Orr, Ray Bourque, a couple of guys that played the offside and played pretty well. You know.
Did it okay.
You may have heard it.
Could have had a better group. Zipped out to center. Avalanche have got it. Chased down by Max Talbot. They'll give it to Nick Holden. Endman pass for Mitchell. Stolen from him. And the shot is tipped. Out of play. And we'll be back. More play from the first period in Calgary with the Flames on a Chris Russell goal leading 1-0.
Wonderful to see all of these people, former Colorado Avalanche coaches, players. But I think for Bob Hartley, it's just good that he is back in the game. Bob Hartley is, Mike, is a tremendous coach. There's no getting around it. His days with the Avalanche, you look at the numbers that he had with the Colorado Avalanche. And I guess, Mike, it always comes down to that one great time when they won a Stanley Cup. Something you just never forget. And Michael,
you always have it on your resume, no matter what.
Exactly. That Game 7 was the greatest night ever at Pepsi Center. There's just no question about it.
That was a lot of fun. Get it. Brings the puck in. He shoots, and the puck is tipped out of play.
They get it last night, Mike. It was one of those nights that, you know, you got to rebound from. You know, a couple of minuses in that game, but you know what? This is where he has to show the coaching staff. But yeah, you know what? You can have a bad game, I bounce back and play a solid game. And I think the Avalanche, the coaching staff, is showing a lot of confidence putting him with Eric Johnson.
Brody sends the puck off the board, sending it down the ice. It'll angle towards Jagr. Bounce it off the board to center ice. Russell, quick pass for David Jones. His pass into the middle, picked off. Avalanche got it. McKinnon overskated the puck for a moment. Recovers, took it out in the center. Stolen back by the Flames, brought in by Jones. He shoots, save made. Rebound, bouncing puck. In and trying to fend off Jones. And the puck put into the corner. Flames have it. Pass back towards the point for Russell. He's got the goal in the game. Shot towards the net, and that one floats over the net. Everybody looking for it. It landed back behind the Avalanche cage. Eric Johnson makes the pass of Bice for Landeskog. Bounced into the middle circle. Went back for Brody. And Giordano carrying past the red line. Tipped it in. Giordano hustling after the puck. Former Flame Corey Sarge plays it. And O'Reilly sends a pass to center ice for Parenteau. With Stastny. They crisscross and give to Stastny. Going to send it back and cross for Parenteau. Or O'Reilly. Goes behind them and sent back out to center. Avalanche got the puck again. 7:50 remaining in this period. 9-2 shot advantage for the Flames. Helped by a couple of power play goals when they had the puck for a long time in the Avalanche zone. And resulted in one power play goal. They lead it 1-0. Long pass. Left by Bortolo. Spun around the boards. And out to center. Well, Bortolo had a big fight last night. If you're thinking, well, will we see a rematch with Bortolo and McGrattan? Well, McGrattan not in the lineup. Oh, here we go. We got a little something happening, though. Cody McLeod is dropping the gloves with Lane McDermott. McLeod and McDermott. Right hand by McDermott. Then he staggered back. McLeod came right back at him. And then he threw him down to the ice, picked him up. A big round right hand by McDermott. Missed the upper cut by McLeod. He's got him in a good headlock, trying to twist him and then throw a punch. He escapes one right hand. McLeod and McDermott then go down to the ice.
Oh, wow.
Oh, that was some bout.
Well, that all happened because McDermott ran over Jagr. I mean, he skated right through the crease. Here's the play right here, as you see. But Mike, I mean, you can't do it any more obviously than that. I mean, that is, you are running into the goaltender. I mean, fortunately for Jagr, he wasn't hurt on the play.
Especially, you don't see it coming.
You're looking the other way, and a guy just runs you over.
Let's see how these penalties are handed out with 7:21 left in the first period. There's McDermott. Here, Cody McLeod, did he left. Go to the locker room?
Oh, yeah, he went to the locker room.
You see the captains, Gabe Landeskog and Mark Giordano.
He got two for goaltender interference. Well, he got his money's worth. Now, is he, are they going to say that McLeod started this? I mean, 2-5-10?
Is that going to
negate
it if he initiated the fight? Still waiting for the announcement of what these penalties would be.
Bortolo is waving to the bench like, should I go over and serve this?
McDermott sitting in the Calgary bench.
The Avalanche have five guys. Just five for Cody McLeod, so. Well, but Michael, that was unbelievable.
So goaltender interference plus a 5-minute major of fighting for Lane McDermott of the Calgary Flames. And for Cody McLeod, he gets 5 minutes for fighting. Whereas McLeod has gone to the locker room.
Now Calgary's coming out, Mike, with five guys, and the faceoff is outside the zone. So
yeah. You know what? They have added now a minor penalty to McLeod for unsportsmanlike conduct. 2-minute minor for unsportsmanlike conduct, not initiating the fight, which would give him an additional 10 minutes.
Right.
But gets an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty along with that 5 for fighting. So, neither team now gets the main advantage. Going 5-on-5 hockey with the Flames leading 1-0 in the first period. 7 minutes left in the period. O'Brien has the puck for the Flames.
Very confusing first period.
Bounced in. And it off to Barry. McGinn has the puck for the Avalanche. Well, a couple of cases, Peter, result involving J.F. Giguere around the crease area. Earlier, Giguere thought that he had been interfered with while he was in the crease. But the goal counted, and then a penalty was given to Giguere, and now what looked like an obvious goaltender interference penalty wiped out because of the unsportsmanlike conduct call given to Cody McLeod.
But that is absolutely not one where the coaching staff or the players are going to say, Cody, what are you doing? I mean, you cannot allow your goaltender to just get run over as he is standing watching the play go behind him.
Avalanche jump on the puck. Big three come out in the center. Duchesne, Landeskog, and McKinnon. Duchesne's pass towards Landeskog got tipped by Russell. Landeskog chases the puck down, gives to McKinnon. Back to Landeskog. And the power's way out of the corner. Elects to go back to the point for Gennon. Rolls it around, hoping McKinnon can reel it in, but it slipped past him and slapped out of the zone by the Flames. Giguere comes out of the net to handle the puck, trying to take advantage of the Flame change. McKinnon on the receiving end will lift it into the corner. Stastny chasing the puck down. He has made a line change as well. O'Reilly comes out from behind the net. Centering pass shot by Parenteau. He was in a good spot, but the shot got blocked. David Jones stood up by Benoit as he chipped the puck past him. And Sarch will take it for Colorado. Makes the pass for O'Reilly up the board. Hudler flagged that down, then O'Reilly took it away. Gives to Stastny. He'll send the puck into the Flames zone. 5 minutes remaining in the first period with the Flames leading this one 1-0. A power play goal at 7:01, still holding up for Calgary. They've outshot the Avs 10-2 in this first period. Sarch bounced into the corner. The puck rolls up the boards, scooped up and carried to center ice. 2-on-2 situation with Stastny giving the puck to Talbot, trying to go wide on O'Brien. Works his way along the boards, trying to force his way out in front. Makes the pass to the point. Shot by Barry, got tipped by Boma, and the puck goes out of play. Well, it's been an interesting night for J.F. Giguere. Thought he had been interfered with earlier. Then there was a goaltender interference call. Let's play a little Did You Know, brought to you by Stevenson Automotive. All right, Paul Stastny and which other Avalanche player at the time assisted on Joe Sakic's 600th career goal here in Calgary? Was it C1, Ian LaPerriere, C2, Kurt Sauer, C3, Ben Hite? Three of the nicest, best people you ever meet in hockey.
When I was downstairs with Lee Blair, we were looking at the names. You go, look at these guys. And it was a wonderful team of people. And these three guys just stood out. I mean, as far as like, what nice guys. So one of them got the assistant in a unique situation, as we'll show you later.
Faced off in the Calgary zone. 1-0 for the Flames. Power play goal by Chris Russell. Right now, the difference. Cleese shot comes through. Pulled up the board. Chopped out to center. Race for the puck. Tyson Berry, nice play. Got there in a hurry. Brought in then by the Flames. Tipped to the boards by Jones. And Berry for the poke check. But Jones follows up. Threw it back behind the Avalanche net. Taken by Lance Boma. Back to center ice, O'Brien with the puck for Calgary. Backing up into his own zone. Lead pass to center ice. Turned off the boards by Jones. Staging from camp up to the puck. And the Avalanche will move to center. Talbot backhands it in deep. Brody for Calgary. With support from Staging, he gets trapped. The handoff from Duchesne. Bounced away though. Flames trying to corral the puck for the Avalanche, and good work by McKinnon. Tap it around the boards. Russell leaves it behind the net. McKinnon jumped on in a hurry. He just flew after that puck, got to it. But Brody can scoop it away. Landeskog, nice play to hold it inside the zone. Boy, this line of Duchesne. Landeskog, McKinnon. They're going after it here on this shift. Landeskog for the Avalanche. Back behind the net. Nice hand-eye coordination from McKinnon. That puck was about shelf high when he knocked it down and played it. Tipped out to center ice. Camilleri with Johnson right on him. Johnson trying to stay with Camilleri. Did a nice job. Stayed right with him. Didn't allow Camilleri to control the puck and get past it. Back to center ice. Avalanche for the puck. Parenteau's pass for Duchesne. Picked off. Brought in by Backlund. His pass. That's a little too far for Hudler. Hudler will bounce on Starch. The puck to the near side wall. Backlund to the point. Giordano with a chance, and that one whistled wide. Far side. Chance for Butler. Bouncing puck right outside the crease. Rolled away by defenseman Nate Ginnon. Brought out to center ice by Devs. B.A. Parenteau. Stastny on it in the corner. And that one is smashed up the slot, but not out. Hudler will turn out to center ice. And
Mike, the Flames don't fool around. They get right in the goaltender's face. They are right down as close as you can get.
About 2 minutes left to go in the first period. Nothing in favor of the Flames, out shooting the Avs 11-2. Scoop back into the Calgary zone. Button after the puck for Calgary. Sent up the boards. Again, jumps on the puck. Moving in, he shoots, kicked out by Ramo. Back around the boards, pushed up the near side by the Flames. Now the Avalanche are spending a little time in the Calgary zone trying to get some dividends from this time spent in the Calgary end. Again, and Mitchell for the Avalanche. Battling for the puck. Mitchell's got it for Colorado. Gets tripped up, and the puck comes back in the corner. Schmid's got it. Turned it up the wall. Slowed up by Mitchell, comes in the high slot. McGinn with a rising shot, misses. And found the glass behind of the goaltender, Ramo. Again, another chance, and that one deflects wide. Back up the far side, Holden holds the puck in, taken away. Look back behind the Calgary net. That's putting on some good pressure. The puck finally comes out to center ice with a minute remaining in the first period. Stepniak will scoop the puck into the Avalanche zone. Tapped in the corner by McKinnon. Avalanche move the puck to center with a quick pass for Duchesne. He's got McKinnon to his left. Going to split through the defense. Gets knocked down. And the puck lands on the stick of Duchesne. Threw it out in front. And the Flames come out to center ice. They try to get some numbers up the ice quickly. Camilleri cutting in. He shoots. Slowed up by Ginnon. Camilleri broke his stick on the play. And Duchesne hustles to center with the puck. 30 seconds to go. Sent over the line for McKinnon. But he was too fast on the play as the Avs are called for being offside. Stop by Cooney Lexus during the December to Remember sales event for exceptional offers on new Lexus all-wheel drive sedans and SUVs. Luxury has an address, Cooney Lexus of Greenwood Village and Colorado Springs.
And Mike, you talked about the Avalanche and the fact that Calgary's had all of these games where the other clubs coming in that played the night before. Well, the Avalanche, this is the first time they've been that tired club. They've had it seven times the other way this season. They're 6-1 in those games.
Riley with a chance, stopped by Ramo, and he covers the puck. No rebound for the Avalanche to get on.
The Avalanche, Mike, again, it's just Riley moving back to that left side. He has been, you know, he's been on the left side for the majority of the season. He's been on the right side for a couple of games when there were some injuries to the Avalanche, but the majority of time it is on that left side, and the one thing he's adjusted from the start of the year, he doesn't look to pass nearly as much. He knows he's a winger. He needs to put the puck on net. He's shooting a lot more.
Stastny to take the face off for the Avalanche. Flames have control. Now the last few seconds of this period. And we'll have another face off in the Calgary zone with a dozen seconds left. And the Avalanche and the Flames just about done with the first period. Flames lead it 1-0.
Let's see what happens here. Calgary had control of the puck. This is a needless icing. So let's see if for the Avalanche, if maybe you can take advantage of it.
Up to Stastny to try to win this faceoff. But it's the Flames who end up with the puck. Giordano played it across for Butler. Cleared out by Calgary. And that's going to use up the rest of the time. One last chance by Johnson. Steered away by Ramo. As the horn sounds to signal the end of our first period of play. So, Chris Russell with his second power play goal of the season at 7:01. There's your difference in the first period.
And you looked at it for, you can see why Calgary's improving. Only five shots on goal for the Avalanche. They were better defensively, and that's what we've been hearing about the Calgary Flames.
There was certainly evidence of that during the first period as Calgary leads this game 1-0. Chris Russell from Bershey and Backlund at 7:01 on the power play. Next up on Altitude is the Toyota Intermission Report. Thank you for watching the Toyota Intermission Report, presented by the Toyota SUV family and your neighborhood Toyota stores. Power play goal for the Calgary Flames. 7:01 scored by Chris Russell. Right now, that's the difference in this game. That's the only goal that got by J.F. Giguere. Peter, you know when you got Giguere in net, he just brings that fire, that enthusiasm, and that competitiveness that you just love.
Well, that passion for the game, the passion for how he plays. And you watch his first period, he was furious with this play. Yeah, it was right on the line. Was it interference? Was it not interference? The referee said no. The goal was allowed. He was upset. He bounces the net off. But then there was a play later on that led to a fight. I mean, he got literally just run over. And thank goodness he wasn't hurt. You can see, he was clearly in the blue when the man ran him, McDermott. And fortunately, Cody McLeod, I just saw him, I was watching, he was talking to the referee. I think he was talking about why did he get the extra, you know, unsportsmanlike conduct. The only thing that I can think of, Mike, and I have to ask him after the game, did he grab hold of the helmet during the fight? Which, you can't do, and because that was as wild a fight as you're going to see.
The fear, I think, initially was that he was going to get initiated, two-minute minor for initiating, which comes with it also a 10-minute misconduct penalty.
Right, but they were both willing participants. I mean, McDermott knew what he had done and that he was going to be involved in something.
Offside Avalanche, they come into the Calgary zone as we are underway in the second period of play here in Calgary.
Yeah, Cody McLeod, good to see him back in the lineup for the Avalanche for a bunch of reasons. One, you just want him back on the bench. You want him healthy. And two, you want your full group of players. You want Patrick Waugh to have those four lines that he can roll, the six defensemen that he can roll in this hockey game until it gets to that point where he needs to shorten his bench.
Flames win the faceoff. Pass it down the ice. Wide of the net. Giguere will handle the puck. Put it into the corner. Blocked on the clearing attempt by the Avalanche. Flames will hold the puck inside the zone. Bounced out to center and Brody on it for the Avalanche. Jason Duchesne got it. Duchesne has the puck. Comes in. He turns. He shoots. The save made by Ramo. Ramo came way out of the net. Cut down the angle on Duchesne's chance. There's another opportunity. Landeskog right in front of the net. Denied by Ramo. Landeskog with 5 points in his last three games. He led the Avalanche in November points. Duchesne slides it out in front. That got blocked, taken away by the Flames. Stepniak's pass. Too far for Camilleri to get to. Corey Sarge trying to clear. Went off of Stepniak. Held in along the far side. Pass across. And intercepted by Corey Sarge. Mitchell. There's the puck to the Calgary zone. Dropped it in the corner. Again after it for the Avalanche. Using that strength of his. Moves up the board for the puck. Drops it off for Mitchell. Coming down from the point is Barry. Drifted the puck. Turned to the corner. Good hustle by McGinn. Centering pass. Taken away by the Flames. Berge. Center ice. One hand to the head. Jones is chased for the Flames. Mitchell for the Avalanche. Has the puck. Scooped it out to center ice. And the goaltender Ramo will cover the puck before McGinn can get to it.
Well, Mark Giordano, Mike, what a valuable player he has been to these Calgary Flames. You're going to watch a play, Mike, in the L.A. game earlier this season. Mike, he played the rest of the game. That was in the second period. He played the rest of that game, went for warm-up the next game before he realized, hey, wait, something's wrong. Well, something's not just wrong. He had a broken ankle. He missed 18 games. Inside of those 18 games, the Calgary Flames were 5-11-2. In the lineup, Mike, so far this year, 9 games. They're 5-2-2.
Well, the first game he comes back, get a goal and assist. And helps the Flames to a victory. their captain. Patrick Bortolo has the puck for Colorado. Gives it to McLeod. Butler took it away. Playing. Pass it. Intercepted. Johnson coming in from that right point spot. And he has the puck inside the blue line. Zips it around the boards. The puck comes around to the near side. And it is pinched in. Both defensemen again and Johnson pinching in, getting involved. Wrist shot, deflected away by Ramos. Centered out in front, and Bortolo in a good spot, but the puck got away from him. Chip out to center ice. Knocked ahead. Avalanche get it back. Long pass off the boards. Put in by Bortolo. He shoots, and the blocker used by the goaltender Kari Ramo to send the puck to the corner. Spun back out to center. Bail back in around the boards by Andre Benoit, the Avalanche. McLeod after it, but the Avs are called for being offside.
I think they're going to call intentional offside on Cody McLeod on this play.
Yeah, the faceoff's coming back in the Avalanche zone.
Well, the Avalanche, Mike, every team will tell you when you're that, you know, when you're that team that played the night before, you want to get through the first period, get your legs. And that's what the Avalanche have to do now. They've got to get their legs and get things going offensively. They got to put some pressure on Calgary.
You know, they've had the last five shots. At one point, they were trailing shots 11-2. Now it's 11-7, so the Avalanche near the end of the first period had the last three shots. Now I've had a couple here in the second period. Haven't allowed Calgary to come back and spend much time in the Avalanche zone. O'Reilly drops the puck in the corner. Brody makes a handoff. Turned back around. Russell makes a quick pass up ice. Brody across the rink. Chased down towards the corner by Paul Bryan. Into the corner. Centering pass in the slot. Shot by Butler misses. The defenseman had pinched in. Behind the net, Byron. After the puck for Calgary. Turned around the boards. Butler puts it wide of the net. That'll pair him behind the cage in the Avalanche zone. Squeezed away by the Avs. Then out to center ice. O'Reilly from the red line. Shoot it into the Calgary zone. Ramo out of the net to handle the puck. Pass up the middle. Carried in. Right to the front of the net. Shot! Big save! Rebound! And it comes across. All of a sudden, Calgary had a great chance to develop. Big time save from Jaguar. Duchesne shoots the puck high. Butler up the wing. And Camilleri into Lee Stepniak. Long pass to center for Stager. Puts the puck in. Jaguar back around the board. Kicked off to Duchesne and Camilleri. Into the corner. Stepniak pass. Too hard to handle for Camilleri. McKinnon. And a skate out of the zone. Puck bounced free. Stajan's got it. Pass to the side of the net. Stepniak trying to get away from Ginnon. Gets the handoff. Centered out in front. But Camilleri was covered the shot. There goes wide. Taken out of the corner. That Stajan bounced it off the boards. Didn't have enough mustard on. The Avalanche able to bury the center ice. It's Aaron Johnson leading the way into the zone for the trailer. Got away from Duchesne, but then the shot slapped wide by Landeskog. Aaron to center ice. Two on one for the Flames. Jones down the slot. Berchi. Oh, boy. The Flames were up on their bench. And so the crowd thought there should have been a penalty on Johnson. Shot. Oh, that one missed. Back up the boards. Duchesne able to clear. And the puck comes to center. I don't know about you, Peter, but I was immediately looking at the referee to see if his arm was going on.
I think, you know, the Avalanche, I'm sure, feel, man, they may have gotten away with one right there. But, Mike, the pace of it has just picked up.
Yes, it certainly has.
And Jaguar made it just a sensational shit save about a minute ago on Camilleri.
Jumped in, Jaguar threw it off the boards. And we got a whistle. And play is stopped here in Calgary. With the Flames leading this one, their 1-0 lead still holding up from the first period.
For Bob Hartley and his club, there's some increased pace right here. But here's the save on Camilleri. I mean, he's their best goal scorer, clearly. And Jaguar made a great save. But here's the play coming across. And And that's why Bob was, you know, was asking the referee, if, you know, about the situation.
Avalanche win the faceoff. And the puck shot into the Calgary zone. O'Brien backcourt. Pair of 55s there in the corner. O'Brien and McLeod. Puck to center. McDermott. And a hit on Holden. Holden back up onto his skates. And the red line chips it in. McDermott came after him again. Back up the board. McDermott. For the Flames. McLeod for the Avalanche along with Leash. Leash with the puck. Held up against the boards. Played it back to the point for Holden. He shoots it off the Leash. Dives for it. Keeps it alive for the Avalanche in the Calgary zone. Hustle for Leash. Looked around the boards. Service pass. Deflects. Comes out to center ice for Bowman. Shoot into the Avalanche zone. Barrett. Long quick pass to center ice for Benoit. That's trying to take advantage of the line change by Calgary. Benoit's shot turned aside by Ramo. 12:45 remaining in the period, and there's another save by Ramo. Pass to center. Going in over the line. Shot saved by Giguere. Goaltenders making their saves. And the puck goes over the glass. Will that be a penalty? Now the Flames think it should be. The referees are going to have a conference to decide if it's going to be a penalty. Spend your holidays with the Avalanche. Pick any four games remaining this season. Get your pick of a signed mini helmet by Nathan MacKinnon, Gabriel Landeskog, or Matt Duchene. Packages start at just $90 at ColoradoAvalanche.com.
Oh, that was, there was some conversation.
It sure was.
And I think Stastny, like, they're saying that it chipped off the Calgary player and out of the zone. But the Avalanche, O'Reilly, he had a great chance right there. So the Avs, like, starting to get a couple of chances. They haven't had too many in this hockey game.
15-10 shot advantage for Calgary. They've got the only goal in the game. Power play goal back in the first period by Russell. Duchene chasing the puck. Got a man in front, takes the shot. And the glove save made by Ramo.
Well, for Matt Duchene, it has been a frustrating time. He got injured in the game, then he missed three games, and now he hasn't scored, Mike, in the last four games since returning. So, or he had one assist last night. So the last eight Avalanche games, he's just accounted for one assist, and they need him. They need him to be that guy that's a night-in, night-out point producer.
Demolary, rushed at by Johnson. Landeskog plays the puck to Johnson. Centering pass for Duchene. Was deflected by Russell of Calgary. Duchene still with the puck. Back to the point for Ginnin. Bounced it off the boards. Landeskog worked it around. Behind the net for MacKinnon. Fights his way in front. Going to make a pass for Duchene. Was sitting right there at the top of the crease. Stepniak for Calgary. Gets through center. Ginnin took it back for the Avalanche. Trying to get out of the zone. Dropped it. Picked up by the Flames. Circling back behind the net. Centering pass in the slot. Shot by Bershey. And that was deflected. Oh, he was in a great spot. The Avalanche did a nice job to deflect that chance away. Bearson out of the corner. Centers, and the puck got by Blair Jones. It goes all the way down the ice. Ramo out to meet the puck. Finds Giordano in the center zone. Shoots it around the boards. It rims to the far side of the Avalanche end. Ginnin to Colorado. Little tip. Trying to get it out of the zone. Brought in by McGinn in the slot. Shot going wide, but taken in the glove by Kari Ramo. He'll hold that for a face-off in the Calgary zone.
Much like the Edmonton Oilers, the Calgary Flames, Mike, will not be a Colorado Avalanche division rival. And it's interesting to see these. It was interesting when it was a time to go and see where the clubs were going to be as far as which division. And the Avalanche, there was a lot of talk they were going to remain in that, you know, Pacific Division with Vancouver, Calgary, and Edmonton. Eventually went to the Central Division and really changed the landscape of who they played more often in the schedule.
Yeah, because there's just three games between these two teams this year. They already had a game which the Avalanche won on November 8th, a 4-2 victory. They'll play again in Colorado. Well, this season, two games in Colorado, one in Calgary. And they'll play again on January 6th, so not that far away. Another month, and they'll be done with their season series. And strange to think of all those years, Peter, they were in the same division and have been in the same conference and never played each other in the playoffs.
That's the one that has always been a stunner, because you know, they were both good a lot of years.
Pass to the corner. Hoodlum gets the handoff. Sends it towards the corner. Calgary moving the puck in the Avalanche zone. Hoodler. His pass got deflected to the corner, but the Flames are right on it. Giordano turns and shoots. That deflects wide. Benoit smacks it around. Butler pinched in. Stepniak turns and shoots. Got it blocked. Picked up and carried in by Stastny. Got a man in front. Stastny pulls up, waits, turns for the trailer. Benoit in the slot. Shot blocked by Giordano. And deflects at the center. Pass across. Almost stolen away by Stastny. Shot in from center. Drop in the corner. Button peels it off the boards. And for Camilleri, he gets checked off the puck. McLeod for the Avs makes the pass. Didn't connect with Bortolo. Gennon sent it out to center. Flagged down by Cleese. And McLeod, he shoots. Glove save by Aramo. And he holds the puck for a faceoff in the Calgary zone. And we'll return halfway through our game. 1-0 Calgary.
Hi, everybody. Kyle Keefe with your Xfinity Sports Break. A couple of big stories this week in the NHL, including one very happy Swede, Henrik Lundqvist. He signed a 7-year extension with the New York Rangers worth $59.5 million. That's $8.5 million a year with a no-move clause. He's a blue shirt for life. How about the Winter Classic? Is it possible to make the big house even bigger? Construction underway. Winter Classic Red Wings Leafs held Michigan Stadium in Ann Arbor, January 1st. Now back to Mike and Pete, second period in Calgary.
Thanks very much, Kyle. We certainly are looking forward to that Winter Classic. And Peter, it's a year in which the Avalanche not participating in any of these outdoor games, but someday it may come. But boy, there's a lot of the outdoor games this year. What are you looking forward to seeing?
The one that I'm looking forward to seeing, because I grew up in Southern California, is Anaheim and Los Angeles. I never thought, in my wildest imagination, that one, there'd be three NHL clubs in California, and two, there'd be an outdoor game. It is so great for that area. It is a terrific hockey area. The Gretzky trade turned California into a wonderful hockey place.
You know, last time we were in Los Angeles talking to people there, I said it's just so fun. There's been so much publicity, discussion about it, and a lot of excitement about that outdoor game. Dodger Stadium. It really is going to be nobody in the country puts on an event like Southern California can do.
And one of the things that when Gretzky came to California, there weren't that many arenas because hockey wasn't that big. Now, there was a huge explosion, but there was a lot of outdoor roller hockey. A lot of kids went right to, okay, if I can't skate indoors, I'll skate outdoors in the roller rinks. And they put up a lot of those. So there has been outdoor hockey, roller hockey, for a long time. But it's just the idea that, you know, with the LA Kings are just a couple of years removed from being Stanley Cup champions. Anaheim, they won the Stanley Cup in 07. So it is going to be a great time.
McKinnon for the Avalanche, charging along that goal line. Give it to Duchesne. Flip pass for Landeskog. Got another chance. Wouldn't be a penalty on Calgary. And the puck is touched by the Flames. Just as Jaguar made his way to the Colorado bench for an extra skater. So the Avalanche will get their first power play chance of this game.
Calgary penalty number 27, 2 minutes holding.
And as we started this stretch of games for the Avalanche, we're going to replay the play, reaching in behind, knocking down, interfering on McKinnon on the play. Mike, the specialty teams and the guys that are important on it have to start to really get going. Last night, you know, the players know they let themselves down. They had an opportunity to stay in that game with some power play, you know, production. And now they need to tie this thing up on the power play.
Calgary scored on the power play in the first. Now the Avalanche with their first chance. If the Avs score on the power play, a lucky winner will get tickets to an upcoming game. For a chance to win, you can register at afwonline.com/altitude. One thing you have to be aware of if you're the Avalanche, certainly important to press the play, try to get the tying goal on the power play. As Johnson has the puck, gives it to McKinnon. But, Peter, this Flames team has scored six shorthanded goals this season. They're the best in the league at scoring shorthanded goals.
They scored six last year, tied for third best in the league, and they've had shorthanded goal in each of the last two games. So you know Bob Hartley is telling them to go.
The leader, Lee Stempniak, he's got two shorthanded goals this season for the Calgary Flames, and there he is.
Look at the penalty killing for Calgary Flames, but I guess it's one of those numbers you go, what? How does this work? How are you 20% higher just playing here as opposed to on the road? And maybe it gets back to the fact for Calgary, Mike, there have been so many of those games where the team played the night before, and they just don't have that offensive energy.
Avalanche, Matt Duchene flicks a pass ahead from Landeskog, joined on the rush by Mitchell. Shoots it around for the waiting Matt Duchene. He gets checked, but gives the puck. Landeskog shoots it wide. Back up to the near side point for Barry. Over to Parenteau, to Barry. His shot kicked out by Ramo. Brody has the puck. And a little soft to toss out in the center. Mitchell has the puck for the Avalanche. It's ahead for Landeskog, tipped back towards the Colorado line. Landeskog gets the pass, hands it off to Parenteau, carries the puck in, gives it back to Landeskog. Cross-ice pass for Duchene, shot blocked in front. There's a chance for Mitchell and covered after making the save by Ramo.
Well, for the Avalanche, moving the puck around, people in front, like we said it so often, but it is just a power play fact. You stand still, you do not score. It just doesn't happen. That puck is not going to find its way through that traffic. You've got to keep altering the lanes, the passing lanes, getting yourself open all the time.
It's on the draw, but Calgary wins the faceoff. Delivered out by Butler. Nick Holden carrying the puck, less than 10 seconds remaining. And this power play chance for the Avalanche. Pass. And he gets a shot, and the glove save by Ramo. Just a couple seconds left in the Smith holding penalty.
That wasn't a real good look at the kind of shot that Nick Holden has. He has just about as good a shot as any of the Avalanche point men. When he winds up, it's got that special pop. And that's one of the reasons why, obviously, he's on that second unit in the power play.
Key face-off here for the Avalanche. Talbot trying to win the draw for Colorado. Get a final shot on this power play chance. He wins the face-off. Got it back to Ginnin. His shot. And that is caught by Ramo. Time for What's on Tap, presented by Coors Light. Please join us again Sunday night. The road trip finishes up in Vancouver. We'll have complete coverage beginning at 5:30. On Altitude Sports, a little earlier start than usual in Vancouver on Sunday.
Which is great for the Avalanche because it means they're going to get home from Vancouver 2 hours earlier. And the tough part about that Vancouver trip is, Mike, there's a day off and then at home against Phoenix. And it is a tough travel. That couple of extra hours will mean something.
Getting home at 2 instead of 4. Again, the Avalanche dances away. Makes the pass to Eric Johnson and pinched in from the point. Again, flicks it back into wide. In the second period, Avalanche have had 11 shots. Calgary's had 5, so now the shots are even. That puck hit O'Brien for the Calgary Flames. Bounced across for Talbot. So each team now with 16 shots in the game. Avalanche have come back from 11-2 deficit in terms of shots. Pounded up the boards to center ice. Hudler against Johnson for the puck. Play continues on. Johnson trying to power his way, and Hudler doing his best to hold him. Trying to get that puck free. And Johnson had grabbed a hold of the blade of the stick of Hudler. Johnson doing his best to hold it against the boards, but it comes free. Giordano, wrist shot right on. Save made by Giguere. He's able to hold the puck. In Calgary, Alberta, the Flames lead the game 1-0.
For a hockey player, but most especially, Mike, for a defenseman down low, when you're trying to fend off an NHL player and you don't have your stick, it is... You're trying anything, everything. You're holding, you're grabbing, you're kicking, you're poking away. And as this play ended, watch this. He goes to chase it, he gets kicked away. He goes, what? Could this get any worse? This is like a comedy routine.
It's amazing how lost sometimes those players feel, right, Peter, when they don't have the stick.
Not just lost, how they feel, how they look. It's just like, oh my gosh.
Flames win the faceoff. Chris Butler, wrist shot. Bounced off a body in front of the net. Less than 5 minutes to go in the second period. Still 1-0 for the Flames. Stages. Pass in front. Starts blocked that attempt. One hand along the boards. Out in front. Camilleri. Backhander missed. Stages chases the puck down. Waves at it. Taken away by the Avalanche. Pushed out from center ice. Giordano for the Flames. Moves the puck behind the net. O'Reilly centering pass. Bounced away. Giordano takes it for Calgary. Bounced out to center. Stepniak's pass. Off the stage, so no icing on the play. Calgary makes a line change. The Avs. Ryan O'Reilly moves the puck ahead for Barry. He winds. He shoots. Kicked out by Ramo. And the puck just taken by Brody before O'Reilly can get to it. Turned around the boards. Held at the point by Barry. His wrist shot blocked. Holden. Nice play to keep it in. Into the corner for McKinnon. Trying to center. And a block. 3:50 to go in the second period. McKinnon had the puck. Russell took it away. Sends it up the boards for Hudlin. Watches that out in the center ice. Holden gets hit. McKinnon, though, arrives with the puck. Then Holden steps up. Pushes the puck into the Calgary zone. Play gets a little tough here in the second period.
It's had sort of different spurts.
Really have.
There'll be a quick set of good offensive chances, then it'll bog down, and then it'll get real hard along the boards.
David Jones sends the puck into the Calgary zone. Butler through the red line. Rimmed around in the Avalanche end. Portillo, one hand of the puck. Comes free for Duchesne. Bursts out to center. Chased down by Byron. They give to Bordeleau in the slot. Shot missed wide by Landeskog. Right at the blue line. Johnson kept the puck in play in the Calgary zone. Sent around the far side. Chipped by McLeod behind the net. Leishafter. He gives to McLeod. Byron trying to prevent him from coming out from behind the net. Shot wide by McLeod. Benoit's shot deflects. Berchin. Chased down by McLeod. And Byron turns the puck back into the Calgary zone. Dumped to the corner by the Flames. Sarge arrived at the puck first. Avalanche Mitchell with Bordeleau. Give to Bordeleau. He'll dump it in. Go to the bench for a change. Steal by Mitchell. Centered. Here's a chance. That's good. And the Avalanche have tied it at one. Mitchell, great chance out of the corner to set it up for the goal. And the Avalanche have tied this game at one.
Big goal for Max Talbot. One for his hockey club, but two for him. That's his first one with the Avalanche. And he's had great opportunities. He's done a great job in different areas for the Avalanche. But you want to get that first one. And he gets it right there. A big one for the Avalanche. It ties this game at one. But, Michael, let's go back and remember just what a big shift Cleish, Bordeleau, and McLeod had just before this. It got the things going for the Avalanche. So this was a continuation of some good offensive pressure for the Avalanche.
Well, Mitchell did a nice job there. He saw that Ramo was going to send that puck around and got to it.
Read it perfectly. But Talbot might also read the play. Because if he thinks the puck is going to go all the way around, then he doesn't belong standing in front of the net. He saw that Ramo was going to make the play, that Mitchell was down low, and he stops right in front, pass out, and did he wire that? I mean, that was just a perfect shot.
Talbot's second of the season, first for the Avalanche from Mitchell. 15-minute mark, so 2 minutes to go. And the Avalanche have tied up this game at one. For Mitchell, he has had now 4 points in the last five games. Excuse me, the last six games. Well, Mitchell been contributing offensively for the Avalanche.
And with Alex Tanguay continuing to be out of the lineup, McKinnon moved up to that right side. This will become a solid third line for the Avalanche. Again on that left side, Mitchell in the middle, Talbot to the right side.
1-1. Avalanche played a much stronger second period. They found those legs. You said sometimes they play that second game. It's a little while to get going, but the Avalanche have outshot the Flames, outworked them at times in the second period, and have been the benefactor of the goal to tie up this game at one. Mitchell carries the center. Sends the puck to the corner. Talbot after it. Talbot has the puck. Good hustle. Talbot goes out in front. Shot. Score! P.A. Parenteau and Max Talbot did another nice job there. Hard work, stole the puck, and then centered out in front for Parenteau, who put the Avs ahead 2-1.
Well, Parenteau scored last night, so he's had a couple of goals the last couple of games, but that was like in one side of one shift. Max Talbot turns this whole game around. One, he scores a goal. Two, he bumps the Calgary player off the puck. Wait, and then just a perfect pass. He didn't just throw it out front. He comes across, and what a beautiful effort at the end of the shift. Start of the shift, he scored a goal. End of the shift, he sets up Parenteau, and boom, the Avalanche go from down one to up one on one Max Talbot shift.
There's 1 minute remaining in the second period. Colorado goal.
It was 2-1 for the Avs, and then the final minute.
Assistant number 25, Max Talbot.
In the period, O'Reilly flying after the puck, trying to center, and that was blocked. In the last two games, only gave up a goal a game. The Avalanche eclipsed that here in the second period. Two goals in this period to take the lead. And there we say it, the Avalanche 16-0 this season, when they've had the lead going to the third period. So 54 seconds apart, Max Talbot turns around the game for the Avalanche with a goal and then a brilliant assist. Set up Parenteau over the go-ahead goal. 15 seconds to go in the period. Duchesne and McKinnon. Offside, Avalanche. With 12 seconds to go.
There's Max Talbot. You and I had a great opportunity to talk to him last night. We were having some fun during the game with Billy Guerin, but Billy was downstairs talking about his time in Pittsburgh with Max Talbot and the year they won the Stanley Cup. We've talked about the couple of goals that Talbot scored in Game 7. And in a 2-1 win. So he's got some winning in him.
That was for the Stanley Cup championship against the Detroit Red Wings. There's the horn to signal the end of the second period. What a second period it was for the Avalanche. Down 1-0 when the period began, and they outshot the Flames, and Max Talbot did the job.
Yeah, Talbot, and that's what you needed in that period. You feel the Avalanche were coming on, but they were frustrated. And Talbot made the plays.
Got the goal. An assist from Mitchell at the 18-minute mark. And then 54 seconds later, he sets up Parenteau with Parenteau's ninth of the season. The Avs lead it 2-1. Stay tuned for the Subaru Intermission Report. Colorado Avalanche Hockey on Altitude is brought to you by Groove Subaru. On Broadway or online at grooveauto.com. KeyBank, unlock your possibilities. Pepsi, live for now. And by the Ford Super Duty. Built stronger, built better, built Ford tough. What a period of hockey for the Avalanche. Trailing 1-0 when the second period began. They outshot the Flames and outscored them 2-0 during the period and lead the game now 2-1. The story certainly during the second period was the outstanding effort of Max Talbot. Great goal. Then he sets up the go-ahead goal with a terrific assist setting up Parenteau. What a great little effort there for Max Talbot.
But on the heels of what Jaguar did for the Avalanche in that second period, the Avalanche got bombed last night. They're down 1-0. They're going into this period. If Calgary gets one more, Mike, it is going to really be tough for the Avalanche. to bounce back. Jaguar did not allow that to happen. The save on Camilleri, maybe the one we're talking about at the end of the game, that really propelled the Avalanche. But for Max Talbot, you know how good this feels. They've been here now for the Colorado Avalanche. He finally gets that first goal. And then right on the same shift, the heels of the shift, as lines are changing, he gets it over to P.A. Parento. And Parento, Mike, puts home his second of the night. And the Avalanche go from down one to up one in about a minute. About as good a shift as anyone's had all season for the Avalanche. Mike, and for Jaguar, Mike, how many times have we seen this? When he comes in, it just seems to have this settling effect on the Avalanche. If it's been a bad game or whatever it has been, you know, you look at the game, and I always go back to that game in Pittsburgh. They got a shot. I think they had 14 shots or 13 shots, and Crosby and Malkin had 15 between them, and they won 1-0.
Part of the six wins that he has had to start this season, 6-0. And now, Avalanche with a chance, leading 2-1 as our third period begins. Colorado this season 16-0. And they take the lead of the third period. Giordano, pass to center. Lifted in, Backlund. Shoots the save by Jaguar. No rebound. Perhaps you're looking for a new car? Go to the all-new Kia at ColoradoKiaDealers.com. Discover the full lineup of high-quality, stylish, dependable vehicles at ColoradoKiaDealers.com.
Oh, there he is, Corey Sarge. Mikey spent 6 years here with this franchise. 379 games he played for this club, and he has brought the same sort of intensity to the Colorado Avalanche. And Mikey has just been solid for the Avalanche this season.
Russell, as the Calgary goal, shoots the puck wide of the net. Step in. Put it back behind the net for Camilleri. Swatted away by the Avs. Talbot back on the ice for the Avalanche. Mitchell push the puck to center. He does. Talbot takes it. Mitchell going down the middle. They've added the second assist on the second goal by the Avs. So it's Parento from Talbot and Mitchell. So Mitchell with two assists in this game. Pass to center. Flex into the Calgary zone. Russell shoots across the rink. Bounce down the ice. Pass Byron. And Jaguar will handle the puck through to the corner. Byron dropping along the boards for Boma. Pinned there by Mitchell, the Avs. But Blair Jones comes away with the puck. Tosses it back behind the net. Mitchell intercepts. Sends it off the glass and out. And Butler hustles back. But as he comes back to touch the puck, the whistle's already been blown, icing the call on the Avalanche.
But Michael, we've got, Mike, I don't think there's any question, as big a return to the city as any player that's ever left. Jerome McGinley comes in December 10th, his first return visit to Calgary since leaving last year, Mike, and it is going to be unbelievable in this town, because there is no, I was reading an article that Al McGinnis said it right. Landon McDonald and Jerome McGinley. And maybe because he's played his whole career, had played his whole career, Jerome McGinley is the number one son in this town.
Giordano makes the pass across. Chris Butler. Berchi. Corner McDermott. Push the puck along the end boards. Well, you and I were here when the trade, yep. we thought it was done. We said there he was going to Boston.
Going to Boston. Where he is now.
Dajan has the puck in the slot. A shot by Stepniak. Broke his stick on that chance. McKinnon blasts his way in. Dropped it. Landeskog over skates for a moment. Turns and shoots. There's a chance. Score! Nathan McKinnon in the right spot to slam in that rebound and make it a 3-1 lead for the Avalanche.
Great setup by McKinnon on his aunt Michael on the pass to Landeskog. Landeskog lost it for a second, but regroups and gets the shot on net. But Mike, when you see McKinnon get the puck, watch what happens. Watch what happens when McKinnon gets the puck. Comes across, wait. Mike, he took that little extra second because he knew he had it. He didn't just whack, put it home. He stopped it. I mean, and again, these are just little instinctive things that he has inside his game. He waits. and puts it home.
The Avalanche are now up 3-1. They've overcome that 1-0 deficit. The second period began. And now with that McKinnon goal, they lead it 3-1, scoring his 6th of the season.
And right there, again, he didn't know what he was going to do. He beats his man to the far side. No one picks him up. He gets it, comes off the goaltender. So you know Mike is automatically going to have a funny spin on it. So he stops it, pops. Stop and pop. Right in that perfect spot.
Here's the key of scoring summary. Nathan McKinnon, 6th of the season. And Gabe Landeskog is the only assist on the goal. For the Avalanche, Peter, this is 3 goals on 4 shots. Bearsheet backhands it out of the zone. Barry trying to shoot the puck ahead and got blocked. 2:28 in the third period. McKinnon from Landeskog. Abs up by 2. Pass across for Stastny. He shoots it. Shoots the puck wide. Stopped that by Byron. Help from O'Brien. He shoots it out to center ice off of Boma. Race for the puck. Jaguar out of the net to play it. Turns it around the boards. It comes free. The chance. And Jaguar came out of the net and deflected that shot. Brought out to center ice by Mitchell. Calgary player just all by himself.
Puck just sort of ricocheted out of the corner. And then again, Jaguar, solid and aggressive.
Backhand try, stopped by Bravo. And Talbot gets wrestled after the save was made.
Let's look at both ends of this play. Puck just sort of, Mike, this was just all of a sudden was there. But you see how far out of the net Jaguar was. Here's the play by Talbot. Talbot, nothing, there is nothing for your confidence like scoring a goal. Go from having no confidence to sky high in one simple shot. It finally goes in. And you saw Talbot coming out of the corner right there. Good, solid play. But did he hit the nail on the head, Mike, in the interview between periods, saying we stayed out of the box? You know, it cost them in the first period, and it cost them last night, and they didn't do it in the second period, and now they're on top.
Got by Sarge back into the Calgary zone. 15:50 to go in the third. 3-1 Colorado. And off to Landeskog. Wide, Rodano. Slow him down, the pass back to the point. Gennon's chance, deflects to the corner. Stager moves the puck up ice for Camilleri. Down the slot. Nice poke check by Gennon, taking the puck away from Stepniak. Stager follows, cuts across, makes the pass back to Giordano. He shoots, and Jaguar had a look at it and was able to make the save.
Well, Michael, this last summer, there was something happened here in Calgary that you had to see it to believe it, I guess. The river rose and literally rushed right through this building. The dressing rooms were completely submerged in water. It went up several rows into the stands. The river was running through the building. It blew out the doors at one end and blew out the doors at the other as the river just rushed through.
That's a lot of work to repair and be ready to go for the season.
They were going 12-hour shifts, 24/7, every single day.
Entering pass for Stastny. Bounced away and the Flames on the move. Pass to center ice. Hoodlum. Handoff. Brody comes right down the slot. Float up and then slapped wide. Wide open net. There'll be a penalty on the Avalanche. There was a great chance for the Flames. But the Avs do take a penalty. Andre Benoit going to the box.
Colorado minor penalty number 61. Hooking.
It's a hooking penalty.
And you can see, Mike, if the Calgary Flames are going to put, you know, generate some offense, it's going to get from their defensemen jumping up into the play. Their defensemen have a good, all of them, move the puck well, jump up into the play.
Benoit in the box. Calgary on the power play for the third time in the game. They're 1-for-2. Jones blocking behind the net. Power play chance for Calgary. Giordano on the blue line. Down the boards. Camilleri pass. Loose in front of the net. Slap kept in by Giordano. Used his glove. There's a chance. Bounced off the backboards. Hudler flings it across. And Camilleri back to Hudler. To the point for Russell. Camilleri's pass to Hudler. In the slot, Jones lets it go free. Over towards Giordano. His pass got slowed up and cleared out by the Avs' Nate Gennett.
Gennett, nice play. Mike, if he just tries to smack that down, it probably doesn't get out of the zone. Took his time and got it down.
Minute remaining in the Benoit penalty. Berchin. Played back, intercepted by Mitchell. Chipped it. And Talbot hustling, but Russell got to the puck, played it away. Berchin for the Flames. Makes a pass for McDermott. Bounced away from him. And tossed down the ice by Sarge. Rommel set it behind the net. The red line. Puck is shot in around the boards. It goes to the corner. Holden for the Avalanche. A little help from McLeod. The puck comes free. Pass across. Nice defensive play by Cleese. Giordano pinched in. Going to be a penalty. And it's going against Calgary. There's 15 seconds left in the Benoit penalty. The Flames are getting called for a penalty.
Calgary minor penalty number 22. Two-way hooking.
A little bit of frustration there. They had a couple of chances, but the Avalanche did a nice job of keeping the puck to the outside. Nick Holden, Mike, kept his ground, didn't let the man get it through. And Jaguar, look at Jaguar. He's at it with those guys running into him. It's good. Listen, if we're going to get it run into, I might as well start it. You know, I want to be the first guy to do it.
Anthony Stepniak in the penalty box for the Calgary Flames. 4-on-4 hockey for 15 seconds. Stastny circles the net. His pass tipped away. Hit off the boards. Stages cuts in. Fakes the shot. And the Flames are shorthanded after on the power play for the second time in the game. 0-for-1 tonight. Andre Benoit, lead pass to center for Stastny. Over to McKinnon. Scored his sixth goal of the season. 18-28 mark during the third period to give the Avs a 3-1 lead. Sent back pass to Stastny. Across to Sarge. Back to Benoit over to Eric Johnson. Round up, fired a pass to Stastny to Benoit. Shot, and that's caught by Ramo. In conjunction with the NHL, the Avalanche will celebrate the history of hockey with some of the NHL's best known trophies. The Avs host the Wild on December 14th. You can get your picture taken with the Stanley Cup. Doors will be opening up at 3 o'clock. Get your tickets. Don't miss that chance.
They just look good. It's a great,
great
picture.
Looking through.
Yeah.
Looking forward to that. December 14th. Parenteau centers for Mitchell, but his shot got blocked. Cleared out by the Flames. 45 seconds left in Stepniak's penalty. Parenteau gets to Duchesne. Tangled up against the boards. Parenteau flings the puck back around. Brody collides behind the net from Landeskog. Landeskog got right back up, takes away the puck. Gets to Duchesne. Finds Landeskog. With a cross by Parenteau. Cross ice pass to Landeskog. Down low. Put it in front. Mitchell had a chance there in front of the net. Shame. Well, they have really moving the puck well. Back for Parenteau. With a cross. One-timer. Knocked down with a glove by Rama. And cleared out by Calgary.
Mitchell was in the right spot. The puck just seemed to slide in between his skates, and he couldn't quite find it.
Couple of shots on that power play chance for the Avalanche. Not able to score. They're 0 for 2 tonight. The man advantage. Russell. The puck settles down. Off to Talbot. Kick to the goal. Romo had to steer that puck away. Back to the point for Gennett. Sent behind the net. Again, glides behind the net with O'Brien.
He's a man possessed right now, Max Talbot, since that goal and assist. This third period, he has been everywhere.
Pass to center. Johnson backing up with the puck. Gennett pass off of Talbot. So no icing on the play. Avalanche changed things up. Flames making a line change as well. Pass to center for Byron. Down the wing. Hudler gets checked by Sarch. Sends the puck behind the Avalanche net. Around the boards. Pass to center ice for O'Reilly. Butler, defenseman from the Flames, gets it to Hudler. Out to center ice. Long pass through the neutral zone for Camilleri. Down the slot. Byron after it. Flames get a drop for the defenseman. Butler put it in front of the net. Shiguer got a stick in the way of the pass. And the Avs are able to clear the zone.
Good defensive traffic down low for the Avalanche. There was really no place for that puck to go.
Put in by Bowman. Calgary into the Colorado zone. Hit by Jones. Jones comes out of the corner with a puck. Bouncing free in front of the net. Smacked that by Giordano and it goes wide. Back around for Landeskog. And the puck to center. Not by Brody. Makes a pass through the middle for McDermott. Delayed penalty coming up on the Avalanche. McDermott has the puck. Pass in the slot. Shot. Big save by Giguere. And when we come back, the Flames will have a power play opportunity. Let's answer tonight's Did You Know question, brought to you by Stevenson Automotive. We asked you, Paul Stastny, and which other Avalanche player assisted on Joe Sakic's 600th career goal that was scored here in Calgary. The answer, your old friend Kurt Sauer, who unfortunately had his career cut short with a head injury with the Phoenix Coyotes, but truly one of our favorite people we've ever been around.
Yeah, but Paul Stastny obviously got one of the assists, but Kurt Sauer, Mike, interesting, you know, Ian LaPerriere had his career obviously cut short because of concussion. It really is something that you just don't want to see on any player.
That a 5.9 for Joe Sakic?
Yep.
Gannon's got a chance coming in shorthanded. He gets upended by Giordano. And that is going to be a penalty on Giordano. Nate Gannon drawing a penalty shorthanded.
We'll be talking to Nate after the game. Turning on the afterburners on that play.
Number 5, Calgary, 2 minutes tripping.
Gannon blocks the puck right at the blue line. And he strides in and see what they're trying to convince you is that he touched the puck first. From our side, that's not what happened.
Missed it completely.
Missed it. Absolutely. I was thinking penalty shot. That's where my mind was going.
That would have been great. Well, Giordano, Bob Hartley didn't like the call, but Giordano into the penalty box for that trip. That ends the power play opportunity for the Flames. It lasted 21 seconds. Now 1-for-4 tonight. 4-on-4 hockey. Russell Hustle. Directed back behind the net. Freed up. And McKinnon carries the center. Makes a pass to the middle for Ryan O'Reilly. Around behind the Calgary net. McKinnon comes free with a puck. Puts his way out in front. Scooped away and carried to center ice by the Flames. Matt Stajan sends it over the line to Mike Camilleri. His shot into the skate. McKinnon scooped up and carried to center ice by McKinnon. Skates in the Calgary zone, cuts across, and his shot goes wide. Meade. Ducks back behind the Flames net. 7:35 remaining in the third period. Avalanche lead by 2 goals. Coming down the middle, Butler shoots, and the blocker save made by Shagir. Shot by Stepniak, blocked in and rolls through the crease. Butler put it out in front, not free. Daring attempt by Parenteau, flagged out, back behind the net by Hudler. Centering pass, right to the stick of Paul Stastny as he picks it off. Hits the center, hits the puck behind him for Parenteau, for a trailer, Barry. Works his way to the boards, turns, backs up to the blue line, gets the puck in the corner. Parenteau, patient with the puck, played it back to the point for Barry. Down the boards for Parenteau. Landeskog's out of the penalty box, and the Avalanche will get a short 21-second power play to give to Landeskog for the corner for Stastny. Back to Landeskog, and the pass comes off the boards and out of the zone. This is the third power play, albeit a short one for the Avalanche. Now 0 for 3 tonight. Shot. Loose puck in front. Smacked at by Duchesne and goes wide. Hey, get up. Knocked in the corner for Landeskog. Kicked along the end boards. Duchesne for Colorado. And reversed out of the net. Out towards the front of the net. Duchesne's got it again. Moves the puck along the end boards. McDermott pushed it up ice. Byron skates the center to the red line. Shoots it ahead. Johnson first to ride for the puck. Gives to get it. Pass off the boards. O'Brien with it back for the Flames. 5:40 remaining. There to center ice. Pushed ahead by Blair Jones. Crash in the corner. Centering pass. Bounce back towards the point. Giordano. Slid it off the skate of O'Brien. Whips it across for Giordano. Nice pass. And Mitchell intercepted that one.
What a nice read by Mitchell. That was a perfect feel for where he should be defensively.
O'Brien, good hit along the end boards on McLeod. And the puck is cleared out. Icing called on Calgary.
Well, John Mitchell has a couple of assists in tonight's game, but look at his stick, my stick. Look at what the stick is for Mitchell. If he comes back and that stick's high, they score a goal. The Avalanche have been working on the sticks on the ice and the passing lanes every single day at practice, and right there's a perfect example of how it shuts down offensive plays. This is a big change in the league. When I first broke in, the sticks were never there. Now these guys are so skilled and so educated about where to have their sticks.
Brian wrestles back behind the net with O'Reilly. Shot by Stastny. Stajan played it up. The Avs keep it in. Holden shot off the skate wide. O'Reilly takes the puck. We're under 5 minutes remaining in the third period. Shot by Stastny off the side of the Calgary net. Smashed around the boards. Out of the zone. Avs Barry plays it back into his own zone. I think Holden will take it for the Avalanche. The Avs have come back in this game, trailing 1-0 until there were 2 minutes left in the second period. And then in a 54-second span, Talbot, Parenteau scored, and then in the third period early on, a goal by McKinnon is giving Colorado a 3-1 advantage.
Mike, on that last ice, that's the one that the players are still learning. That wraparound, and then the puck goes around the boards, and you have to sort of, the linesman have to figure out exactly who was going to get there first. And it's, I'll tell you, the linesmen do a great job in figuring that out, because it is not an easy thing to figure out who's going to get there first, is or isn't it icing.
This is the third time this year, Peter, that the Avalanche have played back-to-back games. They're 2-0 in the what you would think would be the toughest part of it, that second game, and leading this game with 4 minutes left to go by 2 goals. Camilleri has the puck for the Flames. To the point, Brody moves it in. Puts the puck to the corner. Johnson from the knees chips it up the boards. Edge Gordon McKinnon broke it up. Slam back into the Colorado zone. Again, slapped it across. And put into the Calgary zone by Corey Sark. Played off the boards to center ice. Byron, the speed over the line. And David Jones, he shoots, and the save by Jaguar. No rebound. He holds the puck. We'll be back. Yeah, leading by two late in the third.
J.S. Jaguar, there's the play that started the game. A goal for Calgary, took a penalty on the play. They killed that one off, and he got run over, and then he just seemed to get bad. He made a couple of saves when it was 1-0. It would have made it 2-0 for Calgary, and then the Avalanche on the heels of last night. Maybe you're reeling a little bit. So instead of that, Mike, they score the first one, they score the second one, and they have been in pretty much complete control here in the third period. Calgary's worked hard, they've had some chances, but the Avalanche have scored the only goal and been the better club.
Now there's 3:19 left to go. Backward, back to the point. Giordano with that opportunity. Jaguar's got it in his glove. Another face-off in the Colorado zone.
Just watching for the Avalanche again, Mike. We talked about the fact that Jan Hede was not in the lineup tonight, and there were 22, 23 tough minutes that are going to have to be spread over the Avalanche defensemen, and they have done a terrific job.
Point Giordano's shot gets deflected. Talbot sends the puck into his own bench out of play.
That's one of those ones Talbot would want to have back. You just misjudge. You want to bounce it off the glass. Instead, you chip it into your bench. The problem is now the faceoff's in your own zone.
Calgary gets to make the last change. Send out a new group. McGinn needs a new stick. That's why we're waiting for this faceoff. He couldn't skate any slower.
I was just saying, one of the most powerful skaters in the Avalanche, he walked over to the bench.
Bide some time for this faceoff. Mitchell, clean win on the faceoff. Slapped around the boards. And it bounces free for the Avalanche. And it's Max Talbot. We can safely say his best game for the Avalanche.
Absolutely. And part of it is the production. Part of it is the fact he had a goal and assist so far in tonight's game. But there's been so much else that he's done.
And a good line tonight for the Avalanche. Mitchell, McGinn, and Talbot. He's got a goal and assist. Mitchell's got a couple of assists. Shot deflected wide. Bob Hartley has pulled the goaltender. 2:20 left to go and down by two. Rector Skeeter. Nice poke check by Mitchell. The vice McGinn trying to go to the empty net. Deflected away. Rector Skeeter out for the Flames. Down by two. Just over 2 minutes left to go. And this one. The Avalanche trying to get 2-0 against the Calgary Flames. Pass the front tip. Score! Matt Nagin scores the goal. Making it 3-2 with 1:55 to go. So Hartley holds the goaltender and it works. And the 6-on-5 pays dividends for the Flames, and now they're down by one.
And they're just, Mike, just firing people towards the front of the net. Something the Calgary Flames have done all night. They battle down low, get the puck. The 1-2 guys down low. Here comes the third guy. The Avalanche actually had people down low. It just went through the legs of the one defenseman. Perfect play, nice pass, good read, but right there, now Calgary, Mike. I mean, this is one of those ones, plenty of time remaining.
Stages fifth of the season at 18:05. Mike Camilleri, Bruce Russell assisting. Bravo is in the net. Avalanche have the puck. 1.5 to go. Dumped in by the Avalanche. Parenteau tied up in the corner. Camilleri moves the puck up ice. Backlund. Sends it across with Landeskog. Strong play to get to the puck. Turned it around the boards. Ramo has to stay in the net with the puck in the Calgary zone. Brody will get to it, trying to get up the ice. Pass for Russell. Ramo still in the net. One pass to center off the back of the skate of Woodward. Puck dropped back into the Calgary zone. Final minute of regulation. Pass was off McKinnon. Tipped out to center, Giordano. Tripped up by Landeskog. Duchesne takes away the puck. Cuts in, winds, he shoots, and it's deflected wide of the net. Duchesne picked it up, wraparound try. Bounced away, off to Ramo. 40 seconds to go.
What a couple of shifts for the Avalanche. They pinned him down low, they couldn't get out.
Ramo's made his way to the bench with an extra skater. Brody drops the puck in the corner. Jones played it back for Brody. He winds, he shoots, and that went off an Avalanche skate. Agent pass behind the net for David Jones. Centered in front. Oh, and it bounced. Came off the back of the net. Back to Giordano. In the slot. Came a Larry. Trying to fight for the puck. It comes back to the point. Giordano, 12 seconds to go. His shot blocked. It was Duchesne who blocked it. Back to center ice. 5 seconds left to go. Duchesne had the puck. Whistle blown. There's going to be a penalty as Duchesne got pulled down. We've got less than a second left to go in this one. So the Avalanche are going to get the win. They hold off the Flames. A couple of good shifts there at the end, not allowing the Flames to get up the ice and get their goaltender off.
But then they did have a little bit of an opportunity down low in the Avalanche. Look, there's five guys inside the crease, plus the goaltender. There's a lot of bodies down there. Penalty right at the end. Just a little frustration for the Calgary Flames. But the Avalanche pick up their 20th win of the year.
And for Giguere, he'll go to 7-0 this season. And the Avalanche, Peter, 17-0 now when they have the lead going the third period.
And Nathan McKinnon picks up the game-winning goal in tonight's game.
And Giguere, 7-0. We'll get the congratulations for the victory tonight. The Avalanche with a great victory. 3-2, they beat the Calgary Flames. McKinnon with his third game winner of the season. We'll be back in just a moment to wrap things up from Calgary.